नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय।
हरि ओम। त्रिपुरांतकः, दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द लॉर्ड बिकॉज ही डिस्ट्रॉयड त्रिपुरासुरस। सो इट इज सेड दैट आफ्टर तारकासुर वॉज किल्ड बाय लॉर्ड कार्तिकेय द सन ऑफ लॉर्ड शिवा, द थ्री सन्स ऑफ तारकासुर, तारकाक्ष, कमलाक्ष एंड विद्युन्माली, ऑल द थ्री ऑफ देम डिड अ लॉट ऑफ पेनेंस। दे वेर एज स्ट्रॉन्ग एज तारकासुर एंड येट दे did penance, they lived away from all sense enjoyments, they abstained from even food, for many years they lived only on water, after that only on air, many things they did as tapasya, and finally Brahmaji was pleased with them. So he asked them, what boon do they seek? So they said, may we be indestructible, may no one or no being be able to destroy us, make us invincible from our enemies the gods, and make us free from old age, disease and death. So Brahmaji said, that which is born has to die, except Hari and Hara, there is no one else who is immortal, and so immortality cannot be given, you have to choose some other boon. They wanted to be immortal because their logic was, what is the use of all the wealth, sense enjoyments, power, glory, if one day one is supposed to just die? So unless one is immortal, none of these makes any sense. So finally Brahmaji told them that take refuge in Sattva Guna, think clearly and ask a boon which can help you to remove the cause of old age, disease and death. So they thought for some time and they came up with this idea. They said, you give us three cities filled with all riches, comforts, luxuries, conveniences, and those three cities must be indestructible by the gods. They said, we shall move about on the earth and various other places living in those cities. So they are movable cities, mobile cities. Think about it. Not only that, Tarakaksha said, my city must be made up of gold. Kamalaksha said, my city must be made up of silver. And Vidyunmali said, my city must be made from iron and steel. They said, Vishwakarma should make this city and all of them should be made in the same place. They should be made when the sun is in the Abhijit Nakshatra, which is in the afternoon, and moon is in Pushya Nakshatra. They also gave a timeline to Brahmaji. They said, in 1,000 years, these cities must be ready. By the time we come back, these cities should be ready. And they said, when all the three cities come together, with one arrow, Lord Shiva must pierce through these cities. He should be riding a very special chariot, which has all equipments for a war. And with a single arrow, Lord Shiva must pierce all the three cities when they come together in alignment. And then we may be destroyed. And they thought to themselves that they all are worshippers of Lord Shiva. And Lord Shiva will never be able to destroy them. So they felt that they have become immortal. Brahmaji said, so be it. And Brahmaji called Mayadanav, gave him all the specifications to make the cities. After 1,000 years, when the three demons returned, the cities were made exactly as per the specifications. Shiv Puran, Rudra Samhita, Yuddha Kand, chapter 1 gives all these details. Those cities were extremely luxurious, all kinds of facilities, sense enjoyments, palaces, mansions, kalpavrikshas, and also they had, it was not just a city for sense enjoyment. There were many temples, there were a lot of learned men, people who were chanting the Vedas. Every home had a temple. Tarakaksha, Kamalaksha, Vidyunmali, they used to worship Lord Shiva regularly. There were Apsaras, Gandharvas, Siddhas, Charanas also in those cities. Many religious places to conduct Homa, Havan, chanting, spiritual discourses. People were also devout. The Danavas no doubt were enjoying the comforts and conveniences, but they were also devout. They would study, they would do satsang. There were many rivers, rivulets, trees, forests, many things. Each of the cities had even powerful army and great warriors. And these warriors were also devoted to Lord Shiva. everyone there is devoted to Lord Shiva. They follow Dharma. The three demons, they started ruling those cities, and there was peace, harmony. For quite a long time, they were living in this beautiful way. But the devatas were not happy with the brilliance and the noble way of life that the Danavas were living with. The tapasya that all of them were doing, the devotion that they had, the brilliance of dharma and righteousness that was emanating from there, Indra could not handle that. So Indra went to Brahmaji and he told Brahmaji that we are all in distress. The three Rakshasas and my Danav, all of them are causing a lot of trouble to us. So you please think of a way to destroy them. Brahmaji said, they have become great because of the boons they received from me, so I cannot kill them. And the punya that they are generating is quite a lot, so they cannot be so easily destroyed. Now think about it, the asuras are doing all the tapasya, the devatas are living completely indulgently and became insecure. Brahmaji tells them that you have to go to Lord Shiva, please him and worship him. So all the devatas go to Lord Shiva and they propitiate him. Please destroy these asuras. They in fact have troubled all of us a lot, and they even have planned to defeat us. With a lot of shrewdness, Indra and all the devatas, they told Lord Shiva that these three asuras, they are troubling us, tormenting us, and they have even fought with us and they have defeated us. And the sages and the siddhas, they all have been insulted. Holy places have been desecrated. All types of lies were cooked up by the devatas. Now someone may say, how come the devatas cooked up lies? Please remember, they are also jivas. Maybe more meritorious than us, but they also have their own insecurities. Just goes to show that until we don't realize the absolute self, no matter what achievements we have, we will still feel limited, and so there will be some sense of insecurity or the other. So they tell Lord Shiva that these asuras, they have destroyed all yajnas, havan, spiritual practices. The whole world is disturbed and you are the one who destroys such forces to save the world. So before they destroy the world, you please destroy them. Lord Shiva said, all the three brothers are extremely devoted to me. They are following righteousness and dharma, and devatas cannot destroy them, defeat them. So you have to approach Lord Vishnu and see if some solution can be thought of. I am the one who protects those who take refuge in me. They are worshipping me. How can I destroy them just like that? It is also the fact that Lord Shiva knew that Tripurasuras, they have not done anything to the devatas. Devatas have cooked it up out of their insecurity. Along with Brahmaji, all the devatas went to Lord Vishnu and they told the same thing to Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu also told them that where the Vedic Dharma is being followed, there cannot be any evil tendencies and one cannot destroy them. Just like the darkness cannot reach where there is light. In the same way, they are very righteous. They cannot be destroyed. Now Indra and all the devatas got completely disheartened. They become very emotional and they say that how can we do any spiritual practices as long as they are alive? Either you kill the Tripurasura or you kill all of us, devatas. Emotional blackmailing. Devatas take care of the universe also. They are in charge of different parts of the creation. So the devatas say that you kill us. If they have to live, we will die. We can't coexist. Now looking at their condition, Lord Vishnu thought, how can I help them? I am the protector of the universe. Devatas cannot be destroyed. So Lord Vishnu invoked the eternal yajnas and he said that through you, the Supreme Lord is worshipped and the Tripurasuras would be destroyed. The world would be restored to balance. Lord Vishnu told the devatas that with the help of these yajnas, you adore Parameshwara, invoke his grace, and the three cities would get destroyed, world will be restored to balance. Arrangements were made to adore the Supreme Purusha. All the devatas, they also sat. The yajna commenced. And very soon from the yajna kunda, many, many goblins manifested with lots of weapons. The sword and the axe and the trishul and all different types of weapons. They all started rising from the yajna kunda. Lord Vishnu commanded all of them that go to Tripura and destroy all the three cities. Having got their command, when they proceeded to the Tripura, the three cities, they were all reduced to ashes instantly, just like the flies enter into the fire and destroy themselves. All of them in the luster and the tapasya of all the asuras, they all got burnt. The entire army of the goblins got completely destroyed. Just a few of them managed to escape, and they came back and they reported everything to Lord Vishnu. And Lord Vishnu started thinking, all the devatas, Lord Vishnu, everybody was puzzled at what has happened. The devatas were much more distressed. So Lord Vishnu started thinking, what should we do now? He also thought that they are so powerful and they are so established in dharma and righteousness. So even black magic and any other lower ways of destruction also will not work on them. That's the power of being steadfast in dharma. So some other method will have to be thought of. So the daityas were all worshipping Lord Shiva and regularly doing worship of the Shivalinga. Every home had a Shivalinga. So the power of Lord Shiva's worship had made them invincible. And even if some of them died, they would definitely go to Shivalok. So Lord Vishnu thought that we have to create obstructions in their following of the Vedic Dharma. We must create disturbances in their Shivalinga Upasana. We must do things which will make them stop their worships. At the command of Lord Shiva, Lord Vishnu also said to all the devatas that you return to your Devalok, I will think of a solution and I will ensure that you are protected. So all of them, they return. Thereafter, Lord Vishnu created an illusory human from his own body. His head was shaven. He was clad in dirty clothes. A dry sack was hanging from his shoulders and he was carrying a broom. And in this way, he came in front of Lord Vishnu, prostrated and said, O Lord, please tell me, what is your command? What is it that I have to do? Lord Vishnu said, you are born out of me. You have many powers that I have. You will be called as Arihant. He said, you must compose a scripture which has more than 16,000 verses, which are condemning the Vedic teachings, the Vedic rituals, the puja, sadhana, worship of Shivalinga. It should be composed in Apabhramsha language. It should emphasize more on action. It should condemn all the good values and virtues. It should extol atheism, sense indulgence, corruption, violence. And you must go there and spread this knowledge. You must initiate them into this scripture that you write. You must completely confuse them, but you must win over their confidence and they should follow whatever you tell them to follow. Having got these instructions from Lord Vishnu, Arihant created the scripture. He also created 4 disciples and he taught the scriptures to these disciples. Now these shaven-headed disciples belonged to the heretic cult. They had a begging bowl. They had a cloth to cover their face. They wore dirty clothes. They had a broom in their hand and they would walk very slowly. Arihant told them that their goal was to make people live in comfort, take them away from the path of sadhana. Together with his disciples, Arihant now went to Tripura. He had taken the form of an ascetic who has as though controlled the senses. And he laid out a camp there. He started staying there and he started spreading his illusory scripture, started sharing with people what are the things which are written, which are against the dharma, Vedic dharma. The people of Tripura were devoted to Lord Shiva and this illusory dharma did not have any impact on them. So Arihant felt very sad. He remembered Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu remembered Lord Shiva and with his grace, Lord Vishnu remembered Naradji, who came there. Lord Vishnu said to Naradji, you are always engaged in doing welfare of the beings. Arihant has been sent to Tripura to confuse people there. So you please go there and help him. At the command of Lord Vishnu, Naradji also received Diksha from Arihant. And he went to meet Tripurasuras. He told them how he has got initiated and how such a great yogi has come and one should take Diksha from such great people. The Tripurasuras, they thought for a while, but they said if Narad has himself taken Diksha, then we can also try. So they approached Arihant and they surrendered to him and they said, you please initiate us also. Arihant said, I can initiate you only if you promise to follow what I say. They said, yes, we will follow what you say. And in that way, when they got initiated, the entire praja also got initiated. Then that whole city was filled with disciples, semi-disciples and many people who all are initiated into this illusory dharma.